Welcome back to the Middle-earth Shadow of War Gravewalker difficulty walkthrough part 5, where we'll be working our way through the Gondorian questline and pause partway through after we get the last Gondorian artifact to get our gems maxed out.
Survived. How did you find me?
Oh, it was easy. I just followed the trail of dead orcs.
Denedril, did she escape Minasithul?
We were ambushed. I lost her. Many of our brothers were captured. Some remain in hiding. Sauron's armies continue to hunt us.
Idril is resourceful, but no one survives in Mordor for long.
We have a way out. I just need to find her, and whoever's left.
Then we must find them all.
Some of our soldiers were sighted in this encampment.
Tread lightly. We must be careful.
I was at the siege of Minasithul.
So, if you're feeling tough today, then feel free to alert the camp and just rescue all of the Gondorians afterwards. I'll show you the easy way to do it. That's one way, is to just abuse Shadow Strike Pull until you've cleared the camp. Another way is to use your stealth kills and clear each of the Gondorians like that.
Thank you, Ranger.
I smell something.
You can also use your bow like that. Or just charge in and kill all of the orcs.
These orcs will suffer now.
There are more of us out there, Ranger. We can't stop searching.
Savage.
You cannot delay. When you find Idril, escape to the west. Have a second chance at life.
I've already lived two lives. I was born somewhere near Umbra. Herodrine.
That is a long way from Minas Ithil.
My order sent me to Gondor as a guarantee of peace. But the Herodrim had other enemies. I was to return, but by the time I was 10, we lost contact. I lived a good life in Minas Ithil. I was respected. I was happy. And then it fell.
So now you commence your third life.
The only life that matters is the one with Idril. But we have to find her first.
And that we will.
The Uruks use our soldiers as bait. Those are the lucky ones.
Have you managed to free many of your brothers?
Not enough. Some weeks we lose as many as we rescue.
Thank you kindly, Major. I had given up.
I thought we were done for.
So, same thing here. Take out the orcs, rescue the Gondorians.
Take us, Ranger.
Borg, who was supposed to be here, now.
These orcs will suffer now.
Bonkable one.
Okay, he should be fairly easy. We'll just pin him, so we'll keep our arrows for that.
To be honest, I was getting a little bored and a little hungry. And now you're here.
Yeah.
Time to spill some Uruk blood.
I'm in your debt. Captain Baranor.
Karis. Are there any others?
Idril. She's alive. We were on our way to the fighting pits. We were captured. She escaped. If I know Idril, that's where she's headed.
She's alive? She's alive. And dead hope.
We will find her.
We cannot save everyone, Talion. Idril may already be dead.
By my oath, we will find her.
So that quest drops us out pretty close to the next one. We'll just go over and grab it. Bloodsport can be a little bit tricky. You're going to get wave after wave of enemies. At the start of the fight, you'll face a Caragor, so if you can shadow mount the Caragor, that'll help you get the mounted attacks. Other than that, just, you know, try and stay on top of the enemy weaknesses. Pull out all the tricks that our build lets you pull out, and stay alive.
Sport of our misery.
Then we will make misery of their sport.
You kill my beastie, I kill you!
I think we made them angry.
So much the better.
For now, let's deal with these orcs first.
You will rot in
you
Think you've done something special here, don't you? But you can't save them all. You can't even save yourselves.
Krug.
What can I do for you, Master?
Kill his pet!
Oh, you've really got it!
It. I've searched everywhere for you.
And I you.
Come. I'll escort you to Haneth Anu. You'll be safe there.
No. I'm not leaving Mordor. Not till all of our brothers are free.
Come now. We will speak of this later.
My father sacrificed all of Minas Ithil for my safety. I will not be protected any longer. Not by you. Not by anyone.
Idril, you will die out here.
Then that is my fate. But I'm staying. Go. Go, reinforcements will be here soon. We will meet again.
She's a true warrior. She fears nothing anymore.
Yes, that's the problem.
Idril will never leave Mordor. She will fight until she dies.
That's what I'm afraid of.
So this quest is a lot of fun if you have the ability to poison grog barrels from a distance. I like to just sit back, poison the grog barrels, and watch the mayhem. So that's what we're going to do here.
Feel like a bit of treasure hunting?
Every ranger likes to hunt. What did you have in mind?
The Uruks can be relied on for certain things. Their love of blood. Treasure and grog.
I see how you've survived so long in Mordor.
Our numbers keep us from engaging them on the battlefield, so we work by stealth and speed, and hopefully we can escape with our lives.
And a few of theirs.
May this be a feast to remember. We've recovered some of the artifacts that were plundered from the Great Hall.
Every piece of Gondor we take back from them is a victory.
let you guys hear the dialogue too. So after each Grogbarrel you poison, you get some dialogue.
You understand that Baranor fears for your life.
I fear nothing anymore. I couldn't survive here if I did.
Kings of Mordor, and drink to a job well done. Grom's gang is dead, and our good fortune becomes ours. So, drink. Drink, Osrock.
Narkla.
All right, this guy's going to be a little bit tricky, but... he is dazed by stealth, so we'll try and open up with a stealth attack. Not use ranged attacks on him, but on any enemies that are around us. And, just try and use frost against him as much as possible.
He's here. Let's move.
Actually, you know what? No, we won't. We're just gonna sit here and let him drink himself to death.
It's that goblin that thinks cursed.
Running contagion. As soon as they get poisoned, they should go berserk and then start spreading the poison around.
Good with the blade. Health is grown. Stayed awake on night watch. I want something cracked.
Wait, over there. Case in point, these guys down here.
I'm not searching anymore.
device on the right.
You'd better check it out.
If they don't start drinking from the drug quickly, then I'll kill them.
I'd say that was one of our more successful missions, Gravewalker.
I can hardly remember this scared young soldier I met in the lower city.
You mean the one that saved your life from that captain?
That's the one.
We should catch up with Baranov.
Okay, that wasn't nearly as entertaining as I hoped it would be. I thought we'd get more of a slaughter in the camp, but that's okay, we won anyway. So now you've got the Prospector skill. What we'll do is take a break, go out, farm a bunch of gems, and max them out, and then come back and continue on with the Gondorian questline. So I'll show you really quick what happens with Prospector.
See how he is faring.
Talion, Minas Ithil is lost, but Mordor can be ours.
The two towers in the middle area tend to be pretty good for finding treasure works, so I usually sit up here and snipe them. Works much better though if we actually equip Prospector, so be sure to do that first. As you can see, we get carved gems from the normal enemies, and we can get better quality from the Uluks, but we'll just pause the video here, farm up our gems, get everything that we need for the rest of the walkthrough, and continue on from that point. And we're back with all of our gems. So I have 5 perfect life gems now. And 1 perfect warrior gem in the ring slot. As I mentioned in a previous video, I usually use the warrior gem in the ring slot for the increased follower damage. I find that to be more useful than the 30% reduced damage, and I almost never use a wealth gem in the ring slot. You can just wait a little while. When you hit level 60, your chests will give, the silver war chests will give you like level 57 orcs anyway. So you just use a bunch of those, get the orcs that you want, and then toss them into the fight pit a couple of times and they'll be level 60. So no point in using wealth gems. But I find that having the increased follower damage on the captain means he will usually win even against captains. Your bodyguard will usually win against captains that are even a higher level. So I find this to be a good gem. And the other ones are, as I explained, you get 60% increased health, and then any damage you do, you're getting 20% of that back as restored health.
Baranor's scouts will have found more prisoners by now.
Indeed. The orcs are depending on it.
For the wages of war, we'll clear out the camp, and then we don't just fight one captain, we get a little surprise.
Baranor.
One of our scouts reported prisoners here, and far too many orcs to handle alone. Let's each take a flank and meet in the middle.
I'll be there.
But Baranor, we must be careful.
I've given up hope, Ranger. Thank you.
Just moved.
We have to get out of here quickly. You don't understand. We have to leave.
I don't know how you found us, but thank you, Ranger.
Ranger!
I should thank you. See, this soldier here is famous. Not as famous as you, but not all of us has an elf haunting his bones. That's it. Keep your eyes on the prize.
So, no particular strengths or weaknesses. We just take him out normally with the captain. And now for the surprise.
Your captain friend's gone. But don't worry, you'll all be reunited wherever it is the dead men go. Grum.
So, arrowproof but vulnerable to Borgai flies, so let's use a fly ass.
We've got you now!
You can't hurt me! I'll send it!
Fun will
you that's what you want.
They could have killed him, but didn't.
No, they have other plans. They're taking him to Gorgoroth.
We must find Baranor before it's too late.
He is bait, Talion. And he will live until we arrive.
So the next quest is to Gorgoroth, however, before we start that, we'll want to take care of a few things. You'll want to make sure that you have a bodyguard for this area. So I've made Pug the Molten my bodyguard. Vulnerable to stealth, but pretty resistant to other stuff, so he's good. Also disabled the alarms for the bases. Not necessary for you to do that, but if you have the time, you might as well do it. And then I turned off Prospector and instead put on Mindbreaker after farming gems, so I'll just leave it on Mindbreaker from now on. Be sure to, when you get a new ability, that you set it back to the ability that you want. But this is basically how I have my setup now. To Gorgoroth can be a pretty tricky quest unless you have a captain bodyguard. If you have the captain bodyguard, then it makes things a lot easier, but without that it can be pretty challenging. We'll be rescuing Baranor early on after we clear out some of the other enemies, and then trying to keep him and Idril alive. You don't need to help them if they're bleeding if you don't want to, but it helps to have them sort of distract the captain every once in a while.
So much death.
Death would be relief to these men. The purpose of this camp is torture.
Have a cut of pigskin's eyelids off. How they scream.
I don't know why we had to come all the way to Logan's when this fool polished my feet like this.
Constantine.
You've saved me!
Stay here.
Ow!
Goodbye, Ranger, and thank you.
You could also dominate all of these orcs, which would make the fight against the boss easier, but this way is more fun.
Just kill me.
So I kind of like to take the high ground here, clear out the other enemies, take out the other captains.
Fubar.
Yeah.
Gonna stop you in.
Stand, man of the West.
Didn't expect to get hit there, so get my help and I'll shot back very quick.
Hush, Grish.
So basically the strategy with this guy that I'm using is because he's not arrowproof and he's not vulnerable to anything else, I'm just pinning him and freezing him. If he was frostproof or whatever, then I'd probably use a different strategy. But since he's vulnerable to arrows and not immune to frost, then this works pretty well.
What? I can't believe it.
It won't hurt me.
Look next to me. The Bright Lord is your master. I will conquer for you. Understood.
You can do better than that. Come on.
Please.
Fine, fine.
I thought I would die today.
It's not easy being me.
You're injured.
It's nothing. You saved us. Again.
You were right. Staying in Mordor is certain doom. But I cannot leave.
My lady. Then we will be doomed. Together.
So even though we got the Iron Guard skill, I would still stay with Bodyguard. if you have a bodyguard assigned in a zone, then they'll do a lot more damage and be able to take a lot more punishment. So it makes sense to stick with one of the captains. So that is it for the Gondor questline. We'll go with the Atario quests in the next episode. Thank you all for watching. Hope you found it helpful, and see you soon.